This is going to be the first game of the season, of the new season.
A slider for a strike.
Well, I got 4-0.
The windup and the 0-1. Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
When a hitter is showing he's unable to resist those inside pitches, you just might as well keep going in there and hope he keeps chasing. Those weren't strikes, but he wanted to hit them anyway.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going.
Oh, my God.
Bases are empty. One man out. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are.
That's 4 strikeouts.
On the way away now.
And you hit something happened. So got to try the story.
First pitch of the at bat. Too low, 1-0. Albies with a 1-1 count now.
He's certainly done an amazing job right here, grinding to get early two outs with the number two hitter and the middle of the order lurking. He would love to see 3-4-5 with no one on base next inning.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Standing in, Gary Sanchez, as we begin the top of the fourth.
Even though they're up by a boatload early on in this one, you can't get complacent and get lazy. They got to keep the gas pedal down because this team that they're playing can strike and score a lot of runs, too.
And it's 0-2 to Sanchez. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
I don't know why I missed that one.
In now, Whit Merrifield. Second baseman. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. A little tardy
now
there.
No balls and a strike. I play good on that recording.
Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. Ani pops it up. Albies waits on it.
He
makes the play, and there are two gone now.
He could have fielded, but he can't hit.
Now to the plate, the pitcher, Michael Pineda. He reached base on an error and later came around to score last time up. Ooh, started him with the change, and it's nothing in one. Two out, nobody on. Got him swinging, and that will end.
I played horrible on camera.
Standing in, Wilson Ramos. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
The catcher.
Shoots this one over to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So here's the cleanup hitter, Edwin Encarnacion. He singled his last time up.
Yeah, guys, still the only hit in this game so far. They've been pretty well shut down. Guys on the mound have really much controlled the whole outcome up until this point.
Hit hard up the middle. Merrifield brings it in. Throw on to first. He'll take care of Encarnacion for the second out. At the plate, Randy Cisneros. He's 0-for-1 thus far. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that nearly would have gotten him on the board. Instead, it's a long foul ball. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes. Trying to pick things up where he left off, Ken Griffey. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here. Ball one to start the at-bat. And this is sliced hard down the left field line. And this is going to be extra bases here to kick off the fifth. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out. Here's your assessment. It was an RBI sack fly for him last time through. Pitch inside the throw.
What is he doing?
Behind the runner to second. The 1-0 delivery. The runner's breaking from home. Popped up.
Oh, I'm okay with that one.
Now at the plate, Matt Olson. He doubled earlier and carries a 2-for-2 line into this appearance. Here's a high pop-up. Albies is under it. One away. Digging in once again, Trevor Story. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. But he's safe at first as he gets back in time. first pitch of the at bat. And he is safe at second base as the decision to move up pays off, and that'll likely be scored a wild pitch. A ball and a strike to Trevor Story. Spin and a throw back to second. Albies has the tag, and they've got the out at second base. This is line to left. And he'll get there in plenty of time.
Did y'all not see that he said that I was safe? He really looked the safe side.
So striding in.
Leading off for Orlando.
This one doesn't look good.
I can't see anyone. I can't show y'all. He didn't score after all, though. I'm scoring. I cannot hit with him really.
For
some reason. Can't wait till he tries his diamond.
Got him to go up the ladder there for strike one.
This offense has just been flailing at the plate all game long, so it's no wonder why they've only been able to pick up one hit so far. I'm not seeing much of a game plan from these hitters.
Hit in the air out to straightaway left field. Pollock has a read on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. So the base is empty here with one away, and the big right-handed bat of Randall Grichuk saunters into the batter's box next. Well behind that fastball, it's a swinging strike. Fouled off. Line drive to left, and that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit. So a runner at first with one out now, and standing in one of the best two-strike hitters in baseball, Andrelton Simmons. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. And indeed, no look at second. He'll go straight to first and take the sure out.
I'm going to get a rage
quit. Miguel Cabrera will look to provide a little two-out thunder off the bench as he'll hit with a runner at second and two away. And he fouls this one off. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Oh, and two, here it comes. Takes this the other way to right. And that's in there, base hit.
I could have got him out of first, but he wasn't there.
And the runner at third will put the brakes on here as they didn't want to chance it even with two outs.
The left fielder
stepping up now, Brett Gardner. Brett. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. But he's safe at third as he's able to scramble back. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Back
oh
up
my
the
God.
Middle.
Come on, pitcher.
Its way through for a base hit. And the run
not
is
be
in
any
the
worse.
Score from
he's
third.
Not give
makes
up
it
a hit
5-1 contest. Digging in the switch
oh,
hitter,
been Albies.
He went down on strikes last time up. But this will be pulled in out there at second base. And that.
Boone
Logan takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Now batting, Ryan Zimmerman. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. Line drive to center field. And Zimmerman has a base hit. So the leadoff man's aboard in their half of the sixth inning. Striding into the box, A.J. Pollock. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Pollock.
Throw over to the
I'm
back.
Not gonna
and
it.
He will hasten his way back to first
although
where he's in there safely.
I still wouldn't get me out.
Here's the first pitch to him. Line toward the gap in left center. And that's in for a base hit. Make it a 1-for-3 game so far. And he is in there. Now in
come
the
on,
box,
so.
Gary Sanchez. 0-for-2 for him to this point. And a fastball to start things out here. Not close. It's a ball and no
he's
strikes. Runner goes for second. That evens it up 1-1.
He's going to throw back now. He's going to go. Yep,
throw over to first, and the runner will get back standing. On a rope to the second baseman.
Yeah, for the okay. Yeah.
Into the box now with Merrifield, and their runners at the corners now.
Merrifield.
First things first, here's a throw over. But he's safe at first as he gets back in time. Here comes the first pitch. Runners blanking for the plate. Pitch swung on and missed.
Now what are you doing? I didn't tell you to go.
In a rundown, and that is Bonehead City right there.
I did not tell him to do that.
At second with two down. Line toward right center. But he will
run. We all know
Merrifield
can't hit. Well, see, I literally told the other dude to run. I did not tell him to run.
Stepping in,
I wanted to tell him to run. I would have went the other way.
It was a ground out victim last time.
Wilson.
Got him fishing that time, 0-1.
You see that swing right there? You know what that tells me, boys? That this pitcher is doing his job right here. But also,
I'm gonna make some substitutions. I guess I do hitting.
So the offense is obviously not picking anything up today.
And it's fouled away. The 1-2 misses for the second ball.
Hey, I appreciate the fact that he's making him throw a few pitches. Most of his teammates have been hacking at everything that comes their way.
Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time is looked at for ball three.
Hey, did you either get on base or get out? I hate when you see him fall off.
The next 3-2. And this is on the ground for Merrifield at second. And that's out number one. Digging in to try it again, Edwin Encarnacion. One for two. He's singled and grounded out so far. Boy, not even close with that one, and he's behind 0-1.
This guy's been on cruise control as we head into the middle innings of this one. And one of the big factors why, how about 80% of his first pitches have been for strikes?
A swing and a ground ball to third. And there are two away now. Now with the plate, Randy Cisneros. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Fastball just misses. That's ball one.
Well, he's done a great job on the hill throughout this game, and it's something to be proud of anytime you can pitch a good game in this ballpark, especially when it's not your home ballpark.
A ball and two strikes to count now with the bases empty and two away.
Not too often you see a changeup come across at 88 miles an hour on the gun. Still effective when you're
through it right past him. A swing and a miss at the next to hit will be the pitcher, Michael Pineda. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat.
Michael Pineda.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Gotta find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way.
Your attention,
Kirby
please.
Yates is on the pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Yay. I'm not even using my lead pitching. Unless I get in my deep cover.
First delivery to him on the way. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. Towards second, and this will be put away easily for the out.
Can't hit enough drive.
Coming to the plate now.
I ain't gonna warn somebody.
And Griffey.
Why is Hernandez down at 68? Yeah, this one went up. Oh, they're all down. And also one at Sale.
He's set, and the pitch. Splitter swung on and missed, 0-1.
That's just a great pitch right there. Great execution. He just got that hitter to think that pitch was knee-high. Nasty diving out of the zone.
Griffey Sr. behind, a ball and two strikes. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh. Digging in now, Yoenis Cespedes. No hits to this point. Fastball catches the black there for a called strike.
You know, you look at this hitter, he doesn't care about being
down. How do you miss that?
He doesn't care about having two strikes with him. He's got the utmost confidence in his ability to work back into the count and get him something over the heart of the plate.
Another 0-2 home. Got him swinging on the splitter that time, and with that,
we're not even trying at this point.
Settling in now, Kevin Pillar. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Fouled off.
I'm going to end him on a strikeout.
Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
The right fielder, number 13.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. This is hit high in the air out toward left center.
It's going to be his last inning. It's that one.
And he will make the play out there, and there are 2 away now. Stepping into the box. Andrelton Simmons.
Here's a diamond.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Actually, more
just able to get a piece
edge
of that for strike one.
Trevor Story is about to be a diamond.
That's it to short. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. 7 in a row. He's set down now as the side is retired. Riding in, Matt Olson. So far, 2-for-3 in this one.
The first baseman, Matt Olson.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. Nearly.
Come on now.
Here comes the 0-1.
Oh, I didn't mean to.
Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Not a bad pitch there with 2 strikes, but it misses 1-2. Hit sharply on the ground. Albies brings it in. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Trevor Story. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all.
What is his 111?
You can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hold, 0-2. And this is swung on and missed. 2 are quickly retired to start inning number 8.
The batter.
So
the
coming to the plate, Ryan Zimmerman. He steps in off
that
a base hit in
what
his last at bat. No balls
around
and 1 strike. And look out as that one ran in and got him. Into the box.
A.J. Pollard.
Last time through was a base hit. He's set. Here it comes. Pitch inside. The throw. Not in time, as the offline throw allows him to get in there easily. A throw behind the runner at second, but he gets back in time, safe at second base. That swung on and missed. We're even at 1-1. Pulled high in the air out to left field.
Oh, I thought I was going
to
be gone.
Gardner there to make the catch. Inning over.
Come on! Stop going in the pause menu.
So here now's the pitcher, Kirby Yates. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the 8th after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. And now a swing and a miss, and that's what you call establishing the inside part of the plate. It's strike 1. And that's in there as well. 0-2 now.
He's feeling it out there on the mound, just getting the ball and throwing it with a lot of confidence right now.
Struck him out, and he becomes the ninth strikeout victim thus far. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1. And he pumps the fastball by him at 94. It's 0-2.
The discipline has just been completely absent from this offense. Seems like they're always finding themselves behind the count. And a big reason why is they're swinging at all kinds of stuff that's not even in the strike zone.
And that'll bring in the former prospect, Ozzie Albies. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Oh, and look out as this runs in and gets him. The second man he's plunked in this one. Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. 0-2 from him so far in this one. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. Is put in play to the right side of the infield. Merrifield picks it up. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning. Stepping into the box, Gary Sanchez. He'll be charged with trying to get on board, leading off the ninth. Skied in the air to straightaway left.
Come on, people have no power.
And this is taken just shy of the warning track for out number one. Riding in once again, Whit Merrifield. He could really use a knock here, 0-3 in the game so far. A ball and no strikes. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield.
What am I? Why can't he hit? I swear they nut right down the player, they can't hit. You're right, I'm going to Chris Davis.
Chris Davis will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the base is empty. Swing and a miss that time. It's 0-1. High and deep to straightaway right. Richard racing back at the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
That's not even fair because that should have been a home run, but for some reason.
David Hernandez, a right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Now the fastball was swung on and missed.
The first baseman, Edward.
And I'm not sure, but it looks like he may have been blindfolded for that swing. It's 0-2 now.
Real nice curveball there. Had a lot of late break, and he waved right through that one.
Got him to go down swinging there. Edwin Encarnacion goes quietly to lead off the bottom of the ninth. 0-1 the count. On, he takes something off there and had him way out in front for strike two.
So he goes back to back with the same pitch and got him to chase it both times. He's clearly not picking up that pitch very well.
So he was confident doubling up. Does he triple up on it?
It's always tough to go back to back to back. It's not a good idea to show a good hitter the same pitch three times in a row.
Throw to first, we'll take care of him. Score it 2-3 on the put out, and there are two gone now. From the stretch, here's the pitch. First pitch, curveball, swung out and missed, strike one. Swing and a miss, and they're up against it now as they're down to their final strike of the afternoon.
I'll tell you, if I'm pitching right now,
as soon as the last pitch, he loses. He did that on purpose, too. But that doesn't just happen. I wish they got the win. I want Adam Jones. Yes, I got him.
Sesame Street, but the numbers speak like, come on, come on. It's going down, I'm about to free fall. I hold it down like a fat kid on a seesaw. I do it bigger than bigger, I do it big, y'all. I ain't a ball of them, bigger than beach balls. I'm locking loaded, this is pure survival. Fame to keep my eyes.
idols, Biggie and Michael, and ain't nobody talking, making any sense, like people at the show still sitting in the stands. I bet it all at Crow Line. I ran it through the goal line and hit the gold mine. They try to leave me out to dry, hanging from the clothesline. But watch me go with showtime. That's why I pay them no mind. Now let me know if we got
the DRA. Yeah. 1.13. I also have Rip Force, I haven't touched it. Baby, I keep it since I was simple and little. I scribble these riddles to spin your head like a swivel. I talk my way out of pickles. You're talking so superficial. We know it, we know it. I keep it hardcore like fire. I think okay, I think really like Star Wars. I keep it sweating like Rick Ross flip flops. I took my life to my own hands like cross. Don't even try to correct me. Don't even try to understand and dissect me. And keep your mouth shut, you're talking too recklessly. I'm about to cut your line like a... Successfully, I did this domestically without any recipe and kept the integrity. I'm better than I ever been. I'm legend and a gentleman. Pumping like adrenaline, I'm pain relief like medicine. Man, who bumped the turntable? I know you're feeling good, but this could quickly turn... Don't ever stop the music when you rocking like this, cause you could lose a great thing like Tupac and Nas. Let me know if we got what you need.
Get
dribble, bro. You're all playing down.
Oh, I'm living it right now.
I think I got some. Ooh, I'm about to go buy new cards. We need a new second baseman. Because I'm about to go buy money gold. For buying gold cards here for you. I guess we can buy them. Alright, so now I'm gonna go sell Merrifield. I can put him in. My best score. 5% later, revenge. Oh, Merrifield. Now I'm gonna have to do another. This is where you basically turn your thing, like spin a wheel. Whatever team it takes as a player. Alright, whoever center field should have either Arizona, Kansas City, or the Reds, or Arizona. Well, not Kansas City because they have to get rid of it. The Reds. Alright. That's what I got in my thing. Okay, we can go to him now. We can maybe do a relief pitcher or a catcher. Who we got catching? Right, I know who we got catching, but. I used to have this car.
Okay.
see who has to buy. I might buy him back. I'm gonna buy him back. I used to have him. I think he's doing better than Sanchez. I mean, Sanchez could be on the bench. Nah. Your best squad didn't generate. That's my best squad or it does it right there. Bench, not even on the team. Oh, he is. It doesn't matter. That's my revenge squad. I use a generator. Whoever's the first team goes for each position. And there's my pitching generator. That's why I have the Dodge card right here. That card's not horrible, but I mean, it's horrible, but I'm good at it. I think I'm gonna watch the video and press my team out.